Welcome back to the Morning Woodward Show live on the Woodward Sports Network, Detroit's all digital sports network. Thank you guys for waking up with us this morning, being a part of the chat. Always some great comments in the chat, unless you're ripping on Joey for saying we. He kind of takes offense to that, but that's okay.
I feel like everybody here says we at some point for some team.
Yeah.
Just got to do it.
Well, Michigan is your team to say we for. So last night, I was able to watch the Netflix documentary on the Malice at the Palace. Joey, you were able to catch a little bit of it. And what did you think?
Initially, I mean, it kind of came off a little bit weird to me. Like, I felt like all the Pacers were kind of asking for you to feel sorry for me. Like, it was really weird, all of them coming out and sharing their story as to what it was that they felt going through that. And, I mean, what they felt is what every single professional athlete goes through. So I'm not going to sit here and feel bad for you. I know the whole way the situation and then the aftermath and seeing the behind the scenes of them walking all the way through to the locker room. I mean, that was stuff that I didn't really see it. Like, was that the footage that they didn't release? Like,
see,
all the way through to the locker
room. Nothing I saw in the documentary was nothing I hadn't already seen. And that was their whole point. We're going to show you footage that has never been seen. It's like, dude.
Unreleased footage.
Yeah, the only thing I didn't see maybe was the dude with the, you know, the wig screaming into the camera. But
yeah.
We saw that every damn game anyways. Like, honestly, that's the only thing I didn't see. But we have Andy Isaac in here, also known as World of Isaac on Twitter. And what was your response to this? I know I saw your fuck the Pacers.
I wasn't sure if I could come on here and really, like, just let loose with the F-bombs. But I, first of all, let's start off with number one, bad boys for life.
That's right.
Bad boys forever. Number two, fuck the Pacers.
There it is.
Okay? Because that was obscene. Number three, that was actually a good Untold doc. If you like North Korean propaganda, that's
Did
what that
say
was.
North Korea?
That was propaganda, you guys. That was produced by Jermaine O'Neal. That was made for people to feel bad for the Pacers. That was made as if the Pacers were on the verge of some weird kind of alternative dynasty. It was like a Marvel cinematic universe, like, alternative, like, thing. I'm like, did the Pacers win a championship I'm not aware of?
Nope.
I was so confused. The only thing, this was an Untold doc. The only thing I learned from that entire doc was that Jamal Tinsley told Ron Artest, take your foul.
Yes.
That was the only thing that I learned from that documentary. Everything else, we've already seen. We've seen all the angles. Ron Artest was like, let's go frame by frame. Okay, let's go frame by frame. You got hit with a cup. You ran into the stands. You hit the wrong dude. You hit some dude that was like 5'6", 120 pounds, dripping wet. So, like, he's on the floor. Ben Wallace reacts to his stupid foul.
Yep.
He pushes him. If Ron Artest wanted to square up with somebody, why didn't he square up with Ben Wallace? Instead, he hits some dude in the stands, causes this huge riot. Then you get dumbasses coming running on the court. You got AJ Shackelford and Charlie Haddad, who was conveniently on this dock for I don't know what reason. This dude is like 5'6", 300 pounds. So the two people that Ron Artest squared off with combined 5'6", on average, like, one dude was 120 pounds, other dude was like 300 pounds. While Ben Wallace wanted to square up with him that, like, right after that foul.
Right.
And he backed off, and he laid on the scorer's table, and he's the one that, like, was basically antagonizing everyone in the crowd. That doesn't absolve John Green or any of those idiots that were throwing popcorn, throwing beer. It doesn't absolve them, but, like, What was the untold story of that doc? I don't understand.
It was hypocrisy. That's what I was watching. Because, like, to your point, Ron Artest was like, you know, through my therapy, I counted to five. I needed to take a moment to count to five. Yeah, when Ben Wallace pushes your head back, you count to five. When someone throws a cup, you don't count to five,
yeah, apparently. Yeah, that whole meditation, right, Ron Artest, Meta World Peace thing didn't hold water for any viewer that, like, was like cognizant of Ron Artest, like, in the past. It, right, didn't make any sense to me.
Yeah, and another point of hypocrisy that I loved watching last night is Steven Jackson, like, yo, man, we all on the same team. I ride with my boys. I ride. What the fuck do you think us do as fans? Yeah. We ride with each other, too. You attacked a fan. You attacked all of us. Just like when we attacked your teammate, you went into the stands. Like, I don't know. It goes back to don't start no shit, won't be no shit. And, you know, he wanted the heat. He wanted the smoke. He went into the stands. What did you expect the fans to do? Not throw chairs? We're going to throw chairs. It's Detroit.
Yeah. Steven Jackson's, I don't know, like, what the word is, his, like, responsibility for what happened. I didn't really, like, he's like, I went into the stands to protect Ron Artest. Okay, you weren't holding people back. No. You were throwing haymakers at, like, random people that were actually trying to stop Ron Artest from punching dudes.
From punching random people.
Yeah, it was, and, like, you know, like, you actually saw, like, there were people like Rick Mahorn. If you watch the tape, yep, closely, Rick Mahorn is in there, like, trying to hold Ron Artest back from, like, just cold cocking dudes. And it's just like, my bigger issue, like, I actually thought they handled the brawl part better than I thought. Okay. It was everything prior to that, as if the Pacers were on this, like, verge of a dynasty. Like, the Pistons didn't win the title the year before.
Right.
They like, ignored the Eastern Conference Final. Kind of, like, glossed over, oh, the Pistons won. Didn't show the block. They kind of got into Ron Artest's cheap shot in Game 6 that a lot of people forget on Rip Hamilton's face. Remember, he throws that elbow, hits rim. They kind of, like, gloss over it. But, you know, Reggie Miller, Jermaine O'Neal are talking as if the Pacers were going to rip off, like, five or six championships in a row. Reggie Miller called Jermaine O'Neal, you guys. This was the most obscene, absurd part of the doc. He called Jermaine O'Neal the best interior defender in the league, as if Ben Wallace was just some fly on the wall. Ben Wallace was in the middle of four defensive players of the year. I don't even think Jermaine O'Neal ever made a first team all defense. Jermaine O'Neal on the floor was maybe the fifth best defensive player after Sheed, after Tayshaun, after Ron Artest. I didn't understand. When Reggie said that, I'm like, I mean, produced by Jermaine O'Neal,
yeah,
Reggie right, saying these things. The only people they're interviewing as part of, like, the media is Jim Gray. And let's not get into Jim Gray. And then they interview Tim Donaghy as if he has any credibility whatsoever. And they interview the Pistons guy that has a wig. That was it.
Right.
It was like, they interviewed Ben Wallace for like 5 seconds. His cameo didn't even make any sense to me.
That's what I didn't understand. Like, my biggest question to this whole thing was, what was the reason? What did the Pacers want out of this? Because they're saying all this untold. There was really nothing of it that was really untold from that night.
Yeah, they wanted to show that we messed up their dynasty. But, you know, to your point, they didn't even mention that we beat them in 6 games the year before. It's not like it was a rough 7-game series and we, yeah, beat them on the last second. Like, we cleaned them out in 6 games.
Yeah. And then Reggie Miller made it seem like they were going to go on and beat the Lakers in that 2004 NBA Finals. They didn't have the horses to deal with Shaq. The Pistons did. The Pistons had Ben Wallace. They had Eldon Campbell. They had a lot of big bodies to throw at Shaq. And they kind of just glossed over and been like, oh, you know, whoever won that Eastern Conference Final was going to win the NBA Final. Like, let's chill out on this fake, untold Indiana Pacers, like, I don't know, like, fake, like, dynasty. That was my, like, biggest, I think that was my biggest issue with the doc. Not the brawl stuff, but rather that this was made for, like, for people to feel bad for Jermaine O'Neal and for the Pacers and for this, you know, untold dynasty part that just didn't make sense. It really didn't, you guys.
What's up, Art?
Yeah, I think what was depressing about it, too, is the fact that there was a Pacers players crying, and I'll play that clip right now.
Everybody talked about it.
Wait,
every
say
show
it again?
Talked about it.
Violated the number one rule for any professional athlete, and that is no matter what is said, no matter what is thrown at you, you don't go into the stands.
The narrative had changed. It was all about us, the players.
Ron, Steve, JL, it's their fault. They were being thugs. They were acting out of line.
Right, all of a sudden, my character is in question.
It wasn't just the amount of people that were saying it. It was the stature of the people who were saying it.
These are thugs. And everybody else signing off, yeah, you know, it's rap music and this. Well, they're not saying that when hockey is beating the hell out of each other for decades.
They try to use that old hockey excuse right. of, yeah, we went into the stands, but hockey players fight all the time. Yeah, when do hockey players go into the stands?
They don't fight fans like that.
Right. This isn't Happy Gilmore where you try to stab someone with your skate. Like, what the hell was he referring to?
Oh, that just sounds scary. Yeah, I don't get that. My favorite was all the reporters throughout that saying, these athletes out there are like thugs.
Yeah. You know, one thing they really didn't hit on, they caught a lot of the aftermath from the media, like the day after and 2 days after. But if you guys remember, that night on ESPN, the late John Saunders goes on and says, Detroit fans are a bunch of punks.
Yep, punks.
And that was that night. He like laid into the Pistons, and a lot of the ESPN talking heads that night were blaming the fans. And then it was like, wait, let's go back and actually look at what happened. And that's when they were like, wait, the players shouldn't go into the stands. The players shouldn't be, you know, cold cocking fans. So yeah, it was people conveniently forgot about what John Saunders said that night, him laying into Pistons fans. I mean, around here in Detroit,
right,
we remember what he said, but like nationally, I think that part is forgotten.
Well, watch the documentary. I mean, it's worth a view. Like I said, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be, as slanted as I thought it was going to be, but it was definitely correct. A hit piece on Detroit fans, and it was definitely a fluff piece for what the Pacers were supposedly back then.
North Korean propaganda. Literally, North Korean propaganda.
I want to see our side of it. Now that we did see produced by freaking Jermaine O'Neal aspect, I would love to see our side because of Ben Wallace, everything he was dealing with at the time, and just the rest leading up to it, what they actually thought.
If I can, one more thing. In the last year, there have been two basketball documentaries that have pretty much shat all over the Pistons.
Yep.
We had the last dance made like the Bad Boys seem like they were not even a good basketball team and just basically a bunch of thugs that beat up people on the court. And then we have this one. Has any team been shat on more, or any organization been shat on more in a one-year span in two separate docs? What is this?
Just disrespecting champions. That's all. Like, I don't expect anybody to give us the respect. It's Detroit, and that's how we got to earn it. We do it, and we win. And there you go. That's how you shut them the hell up. So thank you, Isaac, for coming on with your rant. Make sure you check out that Netflix documentary. It's fun to watch. There is some good moments in there. You reminisce about the Palace. They did give homage to the fans about how good Detroit fans are, how loyal Detroit fans are, and how rabid was the word that Reggie Miller used. And I can't wait for LCA to get to that rabid level. When we come back, we got our first look at the Detroit Lions depth chart. You guys ready to see who's starting where and who's backing up who? We'll talk about that next right here on Woodward Sports.
I'm looking to bring on another HVAC tech right now.
We are recruiting 5 to 10 techs a month.
We're looking to grow and expand. Every new tech we hire is from Northwestern Tech.
The hands-on training is fantastic.
They're always my first call.
We love hiring Northwestern Tech grads.
They come out trained and ready to work.
Our program is only 10 and a half months, and our next classes are starting soon. So why wait?
I'm looking to hire
a graduate
of Northwestern Tech. Northwestern Tech.
Northwestern Tech.
Northwestern Tech.